Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Amit Wadhwani from Sai Estate Consultants, and one thing that I'm not going to do this evening is to talk about RERA. We received our first communication from Gautamji's office about a couple of months back for certain advertisements that we have released, and I must tell you that since the time we received that communication and today, we have also evolved as a company. So when we talk about brokers, today I have about 198 people working with my company called Sai Estate Consultants, which I found about 7 years back. The way start talking about the broking community, the way when I dropped out of college to join an airline called Jet Airways, and I joined as a cabin crew in 2004, served the airline for about 6 years, started this company, Sai Estate Consultants. I came only with limited knowledge of customer service, learned from the military school of customer service, Jet Airways. In 2010, when I thought of being a broker, there was nobody who wanted to associate with me when I started formulating a team. Back in 2010, that is just about 7 years back, broking was not something an IIM or an IITian would think of. But today, out of the 198 people, we have a sequel of Main Madhuri Dikshit Banna Chahti Hoon. Now everybody wants to start this, Main Anuj Puri Banna Chahta Hoon. That is the sentiment which is there within the company, because broking as a profession has picked up big time in the last seven and a half years. There are people starting from 20,000 rupees a month going up to about 1.2 crore rupees annually is the kind of people that we recruit in our company. There are IITians, there are IIMs who have chosen to work with our company. The way the entire broking community as a whole has changed is very, very exciting. I was at a radio station a couple of hours back, and the RJ asked me, what do you think about sales? How will brokers contribute? So realistically, I feel the brokers also have to take a stand ki kya bechna hai aur kya nahi bechna hai. There are many times we look at bottom line, we look at, okay, 2%, 5%, 7%. But heart in heart, when we are speaking to a client, we know that this product or this flat is something which is not good for that specific buyer. Brokers in this session today will know that appreciation, at least in Mumbai markets, for the next 18 to 24 months, at least I do real estate for about 16, 18 hours every day. I do not see any person putting in money and after an entry load of 17% right out at the outset, any appreciation. In fact, I have been consistently writing and talking about it that if you are planning to make money, my developer friends probably will not like me saying this, but I will still maintain the stand that says real estate, when you buy at 17% entry load, may not give you the kind of returns that we are speaking about to our clients, end users, whether it is the builder sales team or it is the broking community. In fact, mutual funds, equity markets, fixed deposits, debt, all these asset classes are much better. We have been consistently maintaining our stand that if you are planning to buy real estate, if you are consuming real estate, then only think about going to a real estate broker or a sales fraternity. Now, talking about numbers, whether markets are bullish or bearish, I have always believed that in a country like India, where you have immense demand, immense population, it is only about clear communication. So Manishji spoke about our company trying and using innovative strategies. We sometimes use Bollywood celebrities. We try and use mince words, use Hindi, English, everything to reach out to every pocket. Try Inkalab sometimes, try Gujarati Midday, Bombay Times. What are we trying to do? We are trying to reach out to each and every one, basically utilizing the population of Mumbai. Hence, all my developer friends, whenever they speak with me, they ask me, kaisa chal raha hai? We hear about Sai Estate Consultants selling X number of flats. Are you guys only doing affordable housing? So, I am a believer of the fact that everything in Mumbai sells, provided execution is good, communication is clear, the developer's intention is good. So, as far as demand is concerned, I am a big fan of the fact that there is no shortage of money in the market when it comes to subscribing to good properties. But yet, there was a panel discussion wherein we spoke about 70-80% developers or 70-80 developers being wiped out in the market. I strongly feel that there is a great sense of rather an energy flowing within developers where they know that they are in danger. Many of the developers have started looking out for JD and JVs, and they know that ye mujhse nahi ho payega. This is a project that I will not be able to do. Let me hand over the project to somebody else. Let consumers see the light of the day. We have also been working with certain developers who have not done very well in the last 2-3 years. We studied their books. KPMG is on board. EY is on board. They give us all the guidance as far as taking a project is concerned. So, though we look at past history, if we feel that the developer has potential, clear title, we help the developer by getting 100% barter. So, talking about the role of brokers today, it is not only about aapne flat dikhaya, aapne uska token le liya and cheez khatam ho gayi. You have to go an extra mile and see whether the developer needs funding, the developer needs any organized investment, if the developer needs a contractor who can come into play and say, okay, I'll take your 100% inventory on barter, let us sell a 2:1 ratio. So, entire cost of construction can be outsourced to a contractor who will do the bartering. Talking about how 2017 will play, GST, RERA, demonetization, all three things, any change in my view initially is stressful. But if you look at it 3 months, 6 months from now, you look back and see that it was a good change for the industry. Today, so many consumers come in, they don't understand floor rise, they don't understand car park, they don't understand GST. More than selling stuff, concentrate on selling stuff, if we can halt at this point in time, give about 3 months to our businesses and accept that ye 3 mahine mein koi bhi deal nahi hogi. Speaking about brokers or speaking about developers, that ye 3 se 6 mahine mein, I will not have sufficient cash flow. Can I go to banks, can I go to private equity finance options and check whether they will be able to give me a short term 3-year or 2-year stopgap arrangement, because the more desperate, so look at today's paper, we've got 3 jackets, 4 jackets. Okay, the media definitely is encashing on this opportunity where developers and broking community is spending money on advertisements, and we are having a fierce competition within ourselves. If we can educate the, now there are a lot of ads that talk about zero GST impact. I was speaking to a journalist this morning from Economic Times, wherein she was telling me that consumers do not understand what is zero GST impact. She had a question, and I'll discuss that with you. When you say zero GST impact, does that mean ki aapki building mein OC hai aur hence aap GST nahi lene wale ho? Or does that mean that the developer is absorbing GST? GST forms about 12% of the purchase in the state of Maharashtra with absolute no clarity for the consumers. Few developers are saying I'll absorb 6%, while few others saying I'll absorb 12%, while others are offering discount on the baseline. So if we stop, you know, aggressive sales, concentrate on the nomenclature around taxation, maybe come up with plans where we say that, okay, we are not charging for car park, we are not charging floor rise. My base price is 60 lakh rupees. In 2015, I used to sell this at 75. Today, I'm selling this at 60. I'm offering a flat 50%, 15 lakh rupees discount. By, you know, in India is a country where you see a lot of festivities, a lot of buying happens during Dasara, Diwali, I am of the opinion wherein to give gold coins, to give gold bars, free vacations and cars and scooters to people who are buying flats may not work now, because as a middle class family, I will take my wife and kids out on Dasara day and purchase something which is worth 5 grams or 10 grams of gold, but I am not going to cut out a check without doing proper due diligence, without checking the RERA number, background and history. So during this festival period, in fact, give you some very startling numbers, we usually do anywhere between 60 to 75 crore rupees of sales across about 35-40 sites that we man every weekend. So our weekend at Sai Estate Consultants starts on a Tuesday afternoon at 2:30. From Tuesday afternoon 2:30 to Sunday midnight, we sell anywhere between 60 to 75 crore rupees of inventory. A lot of media sales guys came to my office and said, sir, ye 5th se 19th ke beech ka jo period hai, isme aap advertise mat kijiye, because you will not get any response. As per Hindu calendar, it's a very unauspicious period to buy or look at properties. I have documented written proof that between 5th to 19th, my company sold 6% more than we usually sell within a fortnight. So the message here is that main aapko gaadi free de dun, main aapko coin free de dun, Singapore free de dun, lekin mera core product acha nahi hai, mera execution hi nahi hai. I have a sales member team which is 40 people are sitting there nicely dressed, IIM, IITians, JVIMS, Wellinkers, you know, ex Lodha and ex flamboyant companies, but mere site office ke piche jo main site hai, I can count workers that there are only 7, 8, 10 people who are working there. I don't see construction material, I don't see steel, I don't see anything, any activity. Let me tell you, I'm a ridiculous sales guy, because I never followed up with any of my clients more than once. And I tell you, that's the best sales strategy. The minute you call up anybody more than once, वो यही सोचेगा कि सर आपका माल बिकता नहीं है. एंड दिस इज वन क्वेश्चन दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द डेवलपर फ्रेंड्स हैव आस्क्ड मी, डज इट एक्चुअली सेल? यू स्पेंड सो मच मनी, 50-60 करोड़ रुपीज एनुअली ऑन जैकेट्स, ऑन एडवर्टाइजिंग. आई हैव सीन क्लोज टू 300 होर्डिंग्स अक्रॉस द सिटी. डज इट एक्चुअली सेल? द आर्ट ऑफ सेलिंग इज नॉट इन फोर्सिंग एनीबडी टू कट आउट अ चेक, बिकॉज वो चेक आप ले लोगे, कल बैंक करोगे, वो बाउंस हो जाएगा. आइदर द वाइफ विल नॉट लाइक or somebody in the family will not like. But if you only use right communication tools, say this, sir, ye 65 ka flat hai, ye 450 carpet hai, there is no floor guys, main 5 saal ke pehle building bana ke aapko nahi de sakta, main to 5 saal mein banaunga building, then let him take a call ki mujhe lena hai ya nahi lena hai. Lekin you commit 3 years, and then we know that, you know, micro and macro factors will not allow us to execute at the pace. Anybody with, you know, with I am 33 in this area, there are people with 33 years of experience of real estate and related areas. Can we predict what is going to happen in the next 6 months with certainty that January mein you will not have the fourth so-called bullet that will hit real estate and ensure that prices do not go down further? So hence, when it comes to committing on execution, communication, jitna aap transparent, we keep talking about transparency, but heart in heart, all my broker friends, when you sit down, so I am here, the minute I get down, I will speak to my sales director, what happened in the next 30 minutes when I was not online, checking on the sales figure on email or on WhatsApp, he'll tell me, I tried convincing X, we all do it. But what we need to do is, if you see somebody and you realize ki this is not good for that specific person to buy real estate, go walk up to that person and tell that this is not the right time, maybe you can come back to me in 6 months. And this works, because that is what we have been consistently doing. At this point in time, at Sai's end, we end up selling close to about 2000 crores of inventory only from our Mumbai office. There's a new Dubai office, because we believe that the Middle East, UAE audience, we don't sell Damac properties, we don't sell Danube there, we sell the island city in the Middle East, in Dubai, because we feel that Indians settled abroad. First, to aap koi bhi NRI ke paas pe jaiye at this point in time and tell him, I am a real estate guy, aap cheez khareedoge kya? Be prepared to listen to him for 20 minutes of what an NRI feels about Indian real estate. And after you have heard him out, then tell him, main kuch bhi bechne nahi aaya hoon, this is A, B, C. Whenever you are in India, you come down to my office, see the growth. Rera is doing this, Gautam ji is doing this. Our current CM is very dynamic. The minute somebody talks about a dynamic CM or good political structure, you know, that thoughts come ki, you know, maybe this guy has some funding or, you know, something to do with political touch. But I strongly feel that the current environment is most conducive for bullish markets. When I say bullish, the B2B fraternity will feel that I'm talking about prices going up. But no, I am a staunch believer of the fact that prices will continue to correct, because 99.6% of the entire market comprises of whom? Buyers. What do buyers want? Buyers want affordable housing. The vision of 2022. If you have seen our current campaign, which Manish ji's design talks about difficulties that one goes through when you're commuting within the city. And there is a question mark put, why? The answer to that lies in introspection, that these are the difficulties that the consumers face. Can I simplify? Can all of us agree that the next 1.5 years is going to be a difficult ride? Can we tell our companies that 1.5 years I'm not going to make money? I will keep my head above water, and 2019 onwards, it will be a fantastic year, great 10-year run where you can work on decent margins. In the next 18 months, however hard we try, as bankers, developers, contractors, brokers, we will not make money. We will have to accept this fact and then work in that direction. Now, going into Q3 and Q4, I feel that it is definitely the concept of survival of the fittest. But I also agree with people who would say that smaller developers are trying hard. I see a lot of developers between 30 to 45 years old. We write off developers who are of second generation, not giving them enough credit that this was a business which was created by the father and the son is not capable to do this. A lot of young developers today are architects, are engineers. They lack the ability to come to a Mumbai audience or an Indian audience and say that, yes, I ensure that you will get your homes on time and I will give you a product which is something which is world class. So overall, we are quite bullish. If I have to summarize in 60 seconds as to how we manage to sell inventory is, we do not push, we do not call the client more than twice. We take projects up where developers are offering a genuine 25 to 30% discount, and we are positively disruptive. We will continue to stand for consumers, ensuring, educating developers that the next 18 months are slightly sensitive. Please do your 100% in execution, execution, and execution. I do not see any other formula which will bail out the industry from a lull phase to a phase where they will again start making money. On that note, thank you very much.
Well, Mr. Wadhwani, if I may please request you to remain on the stage. And if I may please invite Mr. Vijay Manohar as well as Mr. Anurag Batra to please come on stage to present. I take no gratitude to thank Mr. Wadhwani as well. We have with us Ms. Tripti joining Mr. Manohar on stage to do the honors.